sustain us through this. The word of God is enough. The word of God says that the Lord shall heal us. He's the God that healed us. And he will lift up this pandemic. Yes, he will, in Jesus' mighty name. So what are you saying? I'm defeated. All my children are all now, you know, things are going bad, from bad to worse. Change that narrative like this woman. For she said, that is the message. For she said, it matters what you are saying. There are people who go up the mountains, Catalonia and everywhere, and then when you come back home, you are speaking negative. Speaking negative. Oh, this, the doctor said, we have had doctors tell us things, and we have spoken the word of God, and we have our brother, and he's in the house, praise the Lord. Amen. Brother David, God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. What did the doctor say? He had a tumor in his head, and they said, now you have just a few days to live. But he said, I will not die because the word of God. Yes. You know, is true and is alive. Yes. And today he's alive and he is attending this service as one of the 15 members. Because God has kept him because of what he says. He doesn't say I have a tumor. He doesn't say I have this and the other. He says, I am healed in Jesus' name. And now that is history, that is a Bible. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So child of God, arise and say something. Amen. Amen. Arise and say something in Jesus' name. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
She had substance. I want to close. And I want to say, Psalms 91. Psalms 91, as you just close, is a place that I want to direct all of us to stay. In these times, this woman knew the closet. She had a revelation of the word of God. And probably she had Psalms 91 as a scripture of remembrance in her heart. In Psalms 91, the Bible says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord. And the reason why I quote these scriptures is because we must say, so that faith enables us to receive from God. Hallelujah. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him I will trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers. Under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. I want to repeat the last one. That his truth shall be thy shield and buckler. There are a lot of lies coming along our ways. There are so many voices that we are hearing. Voices of defeat. Voices of new diseases. Voices of you will not make it. Voices of you are not worthy anything. But the truth of God, may the truth of the word of God be your shield and be your buckler in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So we want to come to the close of this service. What are you saying? Are you seeing things in your life and saying negative things? Hallelujah. What are you saying as a child of God? Hallelujah. What are you saying as a child of God? The Bible says in the book of Romans, chapter 10, just want us to be upstanding as we close. Ask my sister to just come. This is Mashira. She will give us some announcements and then we will. Romans chapter 10. I want to speak this word to you who is not born again. That if you say and receive Jesus Christ and you invite him in your life will change. Verse number 6, the Bible says, but the righteousness which is of faith speaketh on this wise, say not in thy heart, who shall ascend into heaven, that is to bring Christ down from above, or who shall descend into the deep, that is to bring Christ up from the dead. But what saith the word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. The word of faith which we preach. That if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. So salvation is a matter of confessing your sins, speaking with your mouth, believing that Jesus was sent from God. If you do that from wherever you are, and confess of your sins that are known to you, the Lord shall change your life, and you shall be born again. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus, for my viewer, wherever they are, as the woman that had the issue of blood beside it. My Father, I pray that there will be a turnaround for my brother and my sister in the Church of Jesus. That for wherever we are, we will go back to our closet. And we will know that truth will be, your truth shall be our battle. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, as my viewer begins to speak the word, which is the substance and the evidence, Lord, you will be pleased with our lives and you will heal us. I pray that you receive the healing of God. You receive the breakthroughs that come from God. You receive the victory that comes from God. Because with God, all things are possible. I speak possibilities in your life as a child of God right now. And from today henceforth, as you go back to the closet and call upon God and say it in prayer, may God heal you. May God meet you the needs that you have. May God meet you at the point of your need in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, thank you for receiving faith. Lord, as we close, like this woman went home whole. Hallelujah. May you sense the touching of your garment by the believer, whoever has had this telecast in this world, as they seek you, as they touch the hem of your garment, may they be made whole in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you from wherever you are. We want to welcome Mrs. Washira. She will just give us announcements and pray for our children, and then we will depart. God bless you.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe kanisa. Amen. So we thank God for that message. Na sita ongelea juu ya hiyo. We are blessed. It's about faith in God. So I'm born again, and it's time for us to worship God with our substance. Amen.
Amen.
So I want to lead us to a people number. We know it. 402-402-297. That's our people number. Let us worship God with our substance. We pay our time. We can have our seats. Thank you. So please take a moment and just give to God, because it is a time to worship God. Worship God with your substance. 402-297, for those who are home. The account is your the purpose for your giving.
Amen.
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 So I'm only giving us 1 more minute, and then after that we'll move on. And I want to reiterate the fact that even out there, because the people number is open 24/7. Every time you can still be able to reach out to God, because God is always giving us something. That's why we are led today. Because God loved us, He's a giver, and He's given unto us. So I would request that you bow down our heads in prayer. We want to pray for our children, and then we wind up this session. Loving Father, we have come before you this morning, Jehovah God, to glorify your holy name and to honor you for who you are. We thank you, Father, for the gift of children, Lord, dear Master. Thank you, Father, that this morning we are coming before you to say thank you that you bless our children, O my God. You have children in our homes, O my Redeemer. We have the little ones, we have the teenage, we have the young adults, so dear Father. But I want to thank you, Father, because all these belong to you, Jehovah God. These are challenging times for us, and at times we stay living in our houses, oh my Father. But this morning, Father, it doesn't matter whatever is happening, Jehovah God. But we want to speak a blessing upon the rest of our children, Lord Jehovah God. We say that they are blessed, oh my Redeemer, they are blessed in the morning. Our children are blessed at noon and even at night, and all the time of their lives they are blessed in the name of Jesus. Father, I want to thank you, dear Jesus, because God, you are telling us to come unto you with anything that is, Father, in case we have any anxiety, Jehovah God, that you should not be anxious about anything, but by prayer and supplication, should make our request be made known unto you, my Father. And seriously, Jehovah God, at times you are wondering what will happen with these children, Jehovah, because there is so much time that is in their hearts, oh Jehovah God. And you know that the devil is not asleep. He may want to disturb their minds, oh my Father, but even direct them towards things that are not glorifying your name, oh dear Father. But Jehovah God, we are coming before you by faith. Yes. And we are united together, Jehovah God. Yes. And we are decreeing and declaring that our children, at whatever age they are, Lord, they will be what you have called them to be, my Father. Yes. And I want to thank you, dear Master, because you are the good shepherd, oh my Father. You are the one that is going to shepherd these children, oh Jehovah God. When they wake up in the morning, oh my Father, they shall hear your voice, oh my Father, Jehovah God. And you shall lead them to green pastures, oh dear Master. You guide their lives, oh dear Master. And we know, Father, because Jehovah God, when you created them, you say in the book of Isaiah, you saw their unformed bodies, oh my Father. And even to the old age and gray hair, it is you who is going to be with them, oh dear Master. And so by faith, we surrender all their lives unto you, Jehovah. We surrender fully unto you, my Father. And we are praying that you shall help us to just take blessings upon their lives. Yes, dear Master, we can come before you and tell you whatever, everything that pertains to them in Jesus. But as we go to them, Father, we shall only speak. We will speak, my Father, that which is positive, oh dear Master, that which is going to build them, oh dear Father, because you know that the power of life and death is in our hands. Yes. Lord, I want to thank you, Father, because you are reminding us, Jehovah, that as we continue waiting upon you, dear Master, that our sons, my Father, shall be like well-natured plants, oh my Father, and our daughters like pillars carved to adorn a palace, oh my Father, and that is what is going to happen to them in the name of Jesus. Father, I want to thank you even for the blessing of a newborn baby for Mama Nimrod, oh Jehovah God. You are continuing to bless us, oh dear Jesus. And I know that this is a gift from you, my Father, even as the other children, oh King Jesus, that you will not add sorrow, but will only make rich and add no sorrow, Father. And that is what we decree, Father. Thank you, dear Jesus. We just want to continue glorifying your name, oh my Master, even as you are providing us what to give to these children in terms of food, oh my Father, and everything else that they need, oh dear Master. We bless and we worship you today, Father, for it is in Jesus' holy name we pray, believing. Amen. So he didn't have a vehicle, but he would pretend that he's driving. Not pretend, but he acted as if he was driving for many years. And that came to be. So the same thing, it could be hard. Can you imagine another person, like our deacon Norman here, with something like a baby toy, driving? Woo! And that came to be. So can we do the same for our children?
Amen.
Get a mental picture of what you want them to be.
Yes.
Then every day, talk to them. Because that which you keep speaking and watering and weeding shall come to pass one day. So God bless you so much.
Amen.
It's really a blessing to be in the house of the Lord. And we want to invite our pastor, Pastor Joe, to send us, to bring us with just a final remark. So thank you so much. God bless you so much.
Had a wonderful time in the presence of God, and we are blessed. So we give him all the praise. So I request us just to stand and share the word of grace. Amen. So this week, go out and speak the word of God. Speak against that mountain that is before you, even as the servant of God has said, and I know that God will come through for you. The God of the mountain is the same God of the virus. He knows you by name. God bless you. Shalom. Let us meet again here on Sunday in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever, Lord. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. We shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.